created, executive produced, and he stars in the upcoming Hallmark Channel original movie, The Christmas House, which just happens to be based on his real life childhood. It's pretty awesome. Welcome back, Robert Buckley. Welcome, Robert.
Thank you for having me.
Good to see you, man.
This movie looks fantastic. Congratulations. I know it's your baby in many ways. It's really a great story. Really, the premise, one family, but three different stories. Take us through it.
So it centers on, it begins with Phyllis and Bill, the parents of these two kids, who are sort of going through some marital troubles, and it's looking like they might be moving out of the house that they raised their boys in. Okay. And they decide, well, you know what, if it's going to be our last Christmas here, let's go big. Let's bring back the old tradition of giving basically the home an extreme Christmas makeover, where it turns the house into an absolute holiday spectacle. So the boys are dragged in. There you see my Jonathan Benning, who plays my brother and his husband, and myself, my little bit. There's the whole family. Look at them go.
Look at that. It looks to me like they're coming together.
And that is the least decorated room in the house, if you can believe it.
I was going to say, I've seen some photos. The house is done up, and it's, you know, brings back memories for you a little bit.
Yes.
Yeah, I know that. Basically, your family did this when you were growing up,
yes.
Didn't you?
Well, there's no half measures in my family. If we find a new hobby we like, we're those people that go to the extreme about it. Like, we can't do anything just a little bit. And Christmas is the best example of that. So my mom and dad just started, like, collecting stuff, and they got into it. And by the time I was in kindergarten, you know, my mom was the classroom mom in my class, and it was, like, public schools were losing funding, so there was, like, less field trips. And so one day she was like, here we go. She's like, we can take the kids to the house, and they can just check it out. That's our house. That's right when you walked in. So we took a field trip. Oh. And all of a sudden, the other kindergarten classes heard about it. And before you knew it, the whole school was taking field trips to our house. And then the other elementary schools in the town. So our house actually became known as the Buckleys were the Christmas house.
Amazing. How long did it take for your family to decorate the house?
And where did you store the stuff, too? Like, this is amazing.
Two very good questions. We had a storage unit completely devoted to Christmas stuff.
Wow.
And we would start the day after Halloween. And if we did it right, we were done by Thanksgiving.
Are you related to Cameron Matheson?
No, listen, I can't even compare.
Cameron really, really loves Christmas, probably as much as your family does.
I've already started sketching out Christmas lights. We've already done the designs. But
he started
before
Halloween. He started sketching before Halloween.
I love that, though.
Yeah.
Let me ask you this, then. When is the earliest you can start celebrating or decorating for Christmas?
Decorating, like you, right after Halloween. That's when we started designing and trying to figure this out. We've already got things kind of going, but not to that extent. I mean, we try.
Your parents must be so thrilled that this movie is being made, because it's truly about your family and what they did.
Yeah, they're so, so excited. But by the way, I'm with you. As soon as I shut the door on the last trick-or-treater, I'm like, it's go time. Let's do this. Oh, there are my folks.
That's amazing.
Yeah, those are the two maniacs behind the Christmas house. And like, we just started collecting stuff. And then Wisely, the local craft store that would, like, carry the animatronic figurines we bought, they just realized as soon as something came in, just call the Buckleys. So they'd call and be like, we got a 6-foot animatronic Santa. And my dad would be like, I'll be there in 5. So it just kept growing.
A direct line to your house.
Yes. Yeah.
And it's so good.
We were their whale.
I really love that. Like, it's so good to see. This is like real life, everybody. These movies are based on real life so often. Okay, so we got a clip from the movie where your character is at the airport reuniting with his brother, played by Jonathan Bennett. And let's take a look.
You're out of order. Handsome Justice? No?
Nothing.
Huh. Sir, all I can do for you right now is put an alert in the system. When your bag is located, we'll deliver it to you.
Oh my gosh, it's Clint Handsome. Oh, can we get a selfie with you? We are your biggest fans.
Yeah.
You guys do know I actually have fans.
Besides our parents?
Excuse me. Can you move to the side, please?
Yeah.
So, Jake, you think you're ready for this?
The legendary Mitchell family Christmas house?
No surface, inside or out, left untouched.
The electric bill alone? Record-breaking.
Construction, painting, hanging snowflakes, glitter everywhere.
And don't forget the trees. Mm. And tons of indoor fake snow.
Mm. But you really think it's going to take all of us 2 weeks to put this together?
He has no idea.
No. It's probably for the best.
Something tells me that was a real scene from your life as well.
I was going to say, that part of not being recognized and people not knowing who I am, directly lifted from
oh,
that.
No, come on. Not
the house, not so much.
That.
This film's
not
really
that.
About me not being famous.
I was talking about the house.
You had to play it down a little bit, though. Yeah. 2 weeks to get the house decorated versus like a month and a half.
Right.
Yep.
Exactly. And was that the first time you ever worked with Jonathan? We love him.
It was. Isn't he the best?
He's great. So funny.
We met on our flight up to Canada to shoot it. And by the time we landed for our connecting flight, we were like,
he's that kind of guy.
Was he hosting like something on the plane? Like, did he take over? Was he doing like a whole song and dance routine? He's that kind of energy. Like, he literally takes over everything.
Yeah, I'd be like,
in the best way.
Should we get a salad or a smoothie? He's like, well, the thing about the smoothies is, I'm like, what are you doing? This isn't Smoothie Wars, Jonathan. Cool it.
All right, listen, the movies looks great, and we want to have a little bit of fun with you. We're going to play a game with you called Would You Rather? We're going to give you two choices.
Okay.
There you go. Home and Family Edition. Two choices, and you tell us which one appeals to you a little bit more. Deb,
okay, you ready?
Here we go.
Would you rather chug a gallon of eggnog, right, or eat a whole Christmas ham?
Oof. Listen, either way, they're both coming back up, so let's go eggnog.
Might be easier that way.
It's going to be quicker. Eggnog's not going to take as long as eating a whole Christmas ham. Would you rather have to sing Jingle Bells every time you walk into a room, or have to wear a Santa suit for every special occasion?
No brainer, it's Santa suit. Two reasons. One, I can't sing to save my life. And two, have you seen how loose and breathy those Santa suits are?
Yeah.
Every special occasion?
Comfy. Yeah.
Every special occasion. Doesn't it? Not around Christmas, just all year round.
Yeah.
4th of July?
Like my birthday party, for instance.
Yeah.
Which I can't wait for.
Oh, okay.
But think about it, you never have to pick an outfit again. You wake up, you do your hair, and you're like, great, I already know what I'm wearing. It's the Santa suit.
Yeah, and you kind of become that guy.
Here comes Robert again.
He's the guy in the Santa suit. All right, it becomes your thing. Would you rather have strings of tinsel for hair or a nose that glows like Rudolph?
Oof. I'm gonna go tinsel hair, because I feel like that's a power move. It's very peacocking. And also, I've had a pimple on my nose before for like 2 days, and I hated it, so I wouldn't want to have that.
No, you keep looking like that,
See how he said that?
True.
He had like one pimple for 2 days, and he's
over
it. I mean, like, that's not bad. He's doing okay.
You guys, shut up.
He's doing okay, and so is this movie, man. It looks fantastic. I love it.
You guys.
Congratulations on all aspects of it. The Christmas House premieres Sunday, November 22nd at 8 p.m., 7 Central, right here on Hallmark Channel.